All right, so what we are getting to know is that the Supreme Court verdict in the Apex Court has been adjourned in the Supertech matter to the 21st of January, that is Friday. So the decision was supposed to come today, the verdict on the Supertech Builders case, with the home buyers aggrieved. And of course, the Supreme Court earlier had also said that the money of the home buyers must be returned to them. Let's get in my colleague Harish, who is joining us with more information. Yes, Harish, over to you. Tell us more about this case, the exact status and the postponement of the verdict, and what would that mean now for the home buyers?
Yes, in fact, some interim orders have been passed, but the Supreme Court has said that the remaining contempt petition regarding a non-payment of dues and the final decision regarding demolition of the towers will be taken on coming Friday, that is January 21st. But there were some very important developments today also. Supertech has said that the Supertech, that is the builder, it has said that it has worked out the money which is to be given to the each home buyer. It has asked the home buyers to give us their the RTGS particulars to the builders, and then the Supertech has assured that it shall transfer money by tomorrow morning. It will start transferring money to the home buyers who are before the Supreme Court from tomorrow morning. This is very, very significant development as far as the Supertech case is concerned. But at that point of time, Advocate Sumit Agarwal, who appears for 9 home buyers, has told Supreme Court that Supertech is only paying to those home buyers who have filed contempt petition before the Supreme Court and not to others. He also, these home buyers also said that there is one amount computed by the home buyers, another amount computed by the builder Supertech, and then the third amount computed by the amicus curiae. But Justice Chandrachud said that for the time being, let Supertech start giving out the money which they find is the correct amount. The rest of the amount can be contested later. And another significant development in the matter is that Noida authority has told Supreme Court that one Mumbai-based firm, Edifice Engineering, has been chosen to carry out demolition of the 240-story towers of the Supertech Emerald Court. So after that, the court has directed Supertech to execute the contract with the company for the demolition work. So, and that has to be done within 1 week. Now the matter has been fixed for January 21st. On that day, the Supreme Court will hear the contempt petition filed by more home buyers. And as of now, it is relief for home buyers who are already before the court, as the Supertech has claimed that they are in the process of collecting RTGS particulars from these home buyers, and from tomorrow morning, they will start transferring the amount. So as of now, the feeling is that the builders have fallen in line after the rap on the knuckles from the court last time around.
Yes.
Because on two counts, that is number one, non-payment of dues to the home buyers, and number two, delay in the decision regarding bringing down the towers. On both counts, the Supreme Court have pulled up the Supertech last time around, but today they have come up with the submissions there. They are complying with the order. So the final order in this regard might be passed on Friday. But as of now, today's developments are something positive for the home buyers, because Supertech has told the court that they have begun making the payments. And also regarding other order, the Supreme Court, the builders have said that a Mumbai-based firm has been finalized by the Noida authority to bring down the towers. And the Supreme Court has asked the Noida authority and the Supertech to enter into a contract with the Mumbai-based firm within 1 week.
Yes, these are very important developments, Harish, that you are updating us with. Those two towers that you're looking at on your screen can actually be raised to the ground. The Noida authority has to tie up with another firm in Mumbai to execute that. So that is going to be significant. First of its kind, in a way where the builders have been made to face the music for the kind of unscrupulous dealings that they have resorted to. And this has happened across India, across other cities as well. Thanks, Harish, for joining us.